the wood itself, in which I put limestone. Limestone, the white, white wash. Over that, we did the painting. So that these areas are left out. So this looks like white, but actually it is a wood. In Kerala mural, white is not used because there is no natural color of white. So we use the limestone background.
So what did you say? The blue color comes from?
Nilamari.
Nilamari is a mineral.
It's a mineral. So we use stones and
metals. Color? Mixture of
Nilamari, that one, the green color. Uh-huh. The green color, again, there are two different ingredients. I'll just take it.
Alwa, and a very tough job. Smooth, thoroughly painted.
In fact,
my instructor appreciated it because I did it only with brush, and it came out so beautifully. So he himself said it's very nice.
So you got.
You come and do it here, or you can do it at home.
I do it at home.
So Nilamari is a mineral, you got it and powdered it and mixed it with?
With water and neem gum.
Okay.
How do you grind it?
So you do it in a coconut shell. So coconut shell you have to prepare. So coconut shell, we need to take out all the rough things and we need to smoothen it out with sandpaper and everything. So it becomes very smooth. After that, you put the stones or whatever, put little water, and slowly with neem gum, you have to just mix it with your hand. With
stone.
Your hand. Yeah, that stone itself will get powdered. And you mix it with your hand. The stone is a powdery stone.
Achcha.
It's a, it is sandstone. Extracted from 220 meters below the ground, those stones. So the instructor got it for us. So we took those stones, small little stones, and we put it in the coconut shell, put neem gum, little water, made it a paste. Then we keep on doing it till we get the right consistency. After that, we do the painting.
So that was the blue. And what about the red?
So that is again chen kallu, red stone.
Okay.
See, this is what
you use what the kathakalinali, that red stone.
Yeah, I'll just because I posted it for everybody. So I'll just show you that.
Maybe it's one of them.
This is how we were making it.
Mm.
But the details, for example, I just show you that. Yeah, this is what it is. So yellow ochre, this is again, this is a stone. The ochre red, again it's a stone, it's called chen kallu. Then blue is the copper sulfate for blue wash, the light blue.
Mm.
And blue shading is nilamari, what I told you.
Mm.
With again, there's something called kattam neelam. All these you get it in the Ayurvedic shops.
Okay.
And then you use curry. Curry is we make with the diya. So diya, we like lamb.
So.
We put the earthen pot above it.
That gets extra oil for it.
We use normal coconut oil.
Okay.
And then we get the soup and then we use that.
You can put ginger oil also, madam.
So black is again the coal, the soot that we used.
And this conception, what is where and how to draw it. So you
these
have something you are following, some tradition.
Yeah.
So you have a traditional.
This is a 500-year-old tradition.
Tradition. So you just have to reproduce exactly.
Exactly, we need to reproduce.
And you have painted it directly on wood.
Directly with brush, yeah.
Wood. So on the wood, you put limestone.
Limestone.
So you got a white canvas like
thing. We put about 20 coats of limestone.
20 times you have to put.
20 times we need to
So put. Each coat,
each
you have to let it dry, no?
Dry, yes. Yeah.
So 20 coats will take a full
about
day.
About one day.
Limestone on the sunna, then?
Sunna.
This temple.
And then?
And once you do that, once it is dried, then we do the drawing on it.
I see.
So we do the drawing on it and...
to get all the perfect proportions.
Yeah, so the drawing, we need to get the proportion of the of the figure that we want to do. So this is a Guruvayurappan.
Okay.
So we just, we know the dimensions. How
okay.
the place should be, you know, how much.
Okay.
So we have a scale for it. So it's a scale and then we draw the whole sketch.
It's a metal or a traditional scale, is it?
It's a paper scale.
Paper scale.
It's a paper
okay.
scale.
Okay, with graduations.
Which graduations?
I see. Once all your traditional things.
All traditional things.
Uh-huh. Angula, it's called angula, like inch.
Angula.
Angula,
correct,
based on angula, 1/16th and all, 1/12th and all.
Yeah.
Okay.
So angular scale we use, and we can use a straw brush actually.
Okay.
But we used a normal brush in this case. And then we start the painting. Either we can draw the measurements also with pencil, or we can do the brush directly.
You
Here
did?
I've done the brush directly.
How long did it take
and
you?
It took me 3 days to complete this.
I see.
Yeah.
So you, after the limestone, that was one day.
Yeah.
And the next day you did the brown?
Next day I did the sketch.
Sketch.
And I started off the painting.
With the brush.
With the brush. Yeah, I did the sketch with the brush and started off the painting also, you know, immediately after the sketch. And then along with the colors, we started progressing and started filling it up once we. So that took another 3 days. Totally, it took about, totally 4 days to complete the whole thing.
So
but
this
we needed about 8 hours of work in one day.
And these, are they look like stones only, these?
Yeah, so those are, it's supposed to be pearl necklace, so there are different types of pearls.
Uh-huh.
So you have the black pearl, the blue pearl, the red pearl, white pearls, it's supposed to be. So it's called a mala. So every part of the god's Kerala murals, every part has a name attached to it.
Okay.
So it's called, this is called the makuta. Then you have, this is
the
earring, you know, for Guruvayurappan you have a specific earring.
Uh-huh.
You can't mess around with the type of earrings and also, if Guruvayurappan, they have that traditionally, that's how it is followed. So it's called a patrakundala. This is called the patrakundala and this is the magaramatsya.
Uh-huh.
Magaramatsya with champaka.
Uh-huh.
So we need to draw it and then this is the bhujakirti.
Uh-huh.
Then you have the vanamala, then you have again the mala, then this is called the niksha.
Uh-huh.
So like that. These are the, and these are the ornaments.
Uh-huh.
Vanamala is a different kind. There are four different kinds of flowers in this.
Uh-huh.
So you have the chimp, puno, different small, I don't remember the names of the flowers exactly.
So the names are also given.
Specific names are there for the flowers, what we can use. So those are the different kinds of flowers that we can use in a sequence. So
and
this is champaka.
Uh-huh.
This one, this big flower is called champaka.
Uh-huh.
And the natural colors, the beauty is that it is very subtle. In the olden days, they used to do it on wall and the stones and all that. If you go to the temples, it's a temple art. So they used to do only on the temples.
It is called sopana chitrakala.
Sopana chitrakala, from where I learned. So. So because it is done on temples, they used to do the brushes that is made out of straw and all that, those things, and then they do directly on the wall. After that, they start coloring with making the same kind of, you know, whatever I explained.
Preparation.
And it's quite a tedious job, but then it lasts for many years, 100 years. You know, you can make it last. Because the preparation work is important, and we cannot do it on a normal canvas. It can only be done on wood or wall. So, and that wall preparation or the wood preparation is again an elaborate process.
And what are those two called? The
Patbataha. This is the peacock feathers. For Guruvayurappan, you have the
two. They're called patakas?
No, I'll tell you. It's called
patakas flag.
It's called
chamara.
Wait, I'll tell you.
Anavattam.
Alavattam.
Alavattam.
It's called alavattam. It's typical of Guruvayurappan, alavattam.
Pattam is round.
Peacock feathers.
Alavattam
arranged in a circular fashion. So
even the number is specified?
Vishnu also, actually.
Yeah.
Vishnu also has it. Vishnu also has a headgear. You know, it's a makuta kind of a thing. Vishnu will have it.
Which is much bigger.
Guruvayurappan doesn't have that.
So she is going to next make a Guruvayurappan full size.
And this one is his janahu, his sacred thread.
Yeah, this is a sacred thread.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So why didn't you put squadron leader Jasmini Chandran here?
I don't remember to use all that.
It would be so nice. Do people know that you are a squadron leader?
I didn't think about
it. Oh, it's a wonderful thing you have done here. remarkable artist.
So this is called Upavita.
Secretary. Yeah.
It's called Upavita.
Yeah. Even in some when we say Upavita, when it's worn like this.
Yajna Upavita.
Yeah. Yajna Upavita.
So most of the figures have it. All the figures actually.
Yeah.